In this lesson, we'll determine the quotient of two fractions using the provided fraction wall. To use the fraction wall, we define the long dark blue rod as one whole. So if we cut or denominate one whole into smaller equal partitions or smaller equal pieces, we can obtain a 1/2 rod, a 1/3 rod, 1/4 rod, 1/6 rod, 1/8 rod, 1/12 rod, and a 1/24 rod. Looking at our first example, we have 2/3 divided by 1/6, which means we want to determine how many 1/6 are in 2/3. We'll begin by representing 2/3. To do this, we would have to use two 1/3 rods. So this train of 1/3 rods would represent 2/3. And now our goal here is to determine how many 1/6 are in 2/3. So now let's take a look at the 1/6 rods. We want to know how many 1/6 rods it would take to make a train the same length as 2/3. So using the 1/6 rods, notice how it would take a total of 1, 2, 3, 4 1/6 rods to form a train of length 2/3. So this tells us there are 4 1/6 in 2/3, and therefore 2/3 divided by 1/6 equals 4. Now if we have loose rods, we can also show it this way. We would start with two 1/3 rods to represent 2/3, and then using 1/6 rods, we would build a train the same length as 2/3. And once again, notice how it takes 1, 2, 3, 4 1/6 rods to form a train of length 2/3, again verifying that 2/3 divided by 1/6 equals 4. Again, there are 4 1/6 in 2/3. Now let's take a look at our second example. Here we have 1/2 divided by 1/12. We want to determine how many 1/12 are in 1/2. We'll first represent 1/2, which would be 1/1/2 rod here. And now to determine how many 1/12 are in 1/2, we want to build a train of length 1/2 using 1/12 rods. So notice how it would take a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 1/12 rods to form a train of length 1/2. So this shows there are 6 1/12 in 1/2, and therefore 1/2 divided by 1/12 equals 6. And again, if we have loose rods, we can show it this way, where we begin with a 1/2 rod, and then using the 1/12 rods, we build a train the same length as 1/2. So notice how it takes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 1/12 rods to form a train of length 1/2, which means there are 6 1/12 in 1/2, again verifying 1/2 divided by 1/12 equals 6. So using a fraction wall can be a nice way to understand what's happening when we find the quotient of two fractions. I hope you found this helpful.